There are so many different accounts of what's happening with the Afghan peace talks. Many people don't know what to believe. From where Pakistan is sitting, do you see signs of a legitimate peace process that's taking significant steps forward?
We have seen a multiplicity of efforts which have gone into various processes. Pakistan has repeatedly said, and we are walking the talk of saying, of doing, that it should be a process which is first sorted out within Afghanistan, that the Afghan people, the Afghan political parties, the Afghan entities are first completely clear as to what is the road to peace and reconciliation that they want
to follow. We've heard that for such a long time, and my impression is you're still not clear on what the road is.
We don't need to be as clear as the Afghans need to be. I'm trying to...
And you're saying they're not clear yet.
I'm saying that they are making very serious efforts towards that.
If you say Kabul may not be clear on what their role is, my guess is you're not clear on what your role is.
No. Well, you know, Pakistan has a crucial supportive role.
What does that mean? Now, what does a supportive role mean?
A supportive role means that what is clearly identified to be Afghan-driven, Afghan-led, Afghan-owned, where Afghans take the lead, Pakistan will assist.
I think the U.S. and Kabul view Pakistan's role as important because they believe that you can bring some serious militant leaders to the negotiating table. Is that something you can do?
I think the perception of what Pakistan is able to do is blown out of proportion most of the time. But in our modest way, whatever we can do, let me assure you, as my leadership, as President Zardari and Prime Minister Gilani have assured their counterpart, President Karzai, that they will do.
Does Pakistan or its intelligence agencies have any access directly or indirectly to someone like Mullah Omar?
Every agency has links with different organizations, different groups.
Do your agencies have links?
Certainly has links. And if the CIA has links, clearly ISI might also have some links. So this is the job of intelligence agencies to have links. Now, what is crucial is that are those links being used positively or are those links being used negatively?
But just so we're clear, one of your supportive roles could be using any links you may have to someone like Mullah Omar, other militant leaders, to help the peace process move forward. Is that correct?
If what you're trying to get out of me is whether we have links with Mullah Omar or not, the answer to that is no.
Not even indirect links?
Now, the U.S., Pakistan are both in the position to play a supportive role. The U.S. has had the most recent interactions with the Taliban in a direct way. And in the last few months, if there are any lessons that we should have all collectively learned, it is that a partnership approach is all that can work.